Welcome to our daily devotional brought to you by Crossroads Presbyterian Church. Our inspiration comes from the Advent Jesse tree. Think of it as being Jesus's family tree. This Advent season, we are looking at 25 stories and symbols that trace the heritage of Jesus from the beginning of creation, as well as connecting with someone from the church. So today, we're talking with Melinda and Grace McCready. Hello, ladies. They live in Plymouth with Bill, and they have been members at Crossroads for just over a year. So ladies, tell us about a significant member of your family tree that's represented by a meaningful ornament.
So we are going to talk about my grandma today, so my mom's mom. And she is famous for her cross-stitch Santas. She started making these in the late 1980s.
Yep.
And stopped probably around 2013 when she just couldn't do it anymore. But she probably made... roughly, my mom says she has a whole tree that she could devote to these Santas. So she has a lot. But they're just kind of a hallmark of our family, a symbol of when Christmas time comes around. We always think about these Santas. We have a picture frame of them that hangs in our house for the whole year. So it's our little piece of grandma and our little piece of Christmas that we see every day. So they're just really important to us and something that I think will pass down through generations too.
Oh, that is very cool. Thank you. It's been so fun to learn about stories from our church community. And in so doing, we also learn about the story of God. So today we have a story from Scripture that helps us learn about Jesus's purpose. And it is the story of the prophet Jonah from the book of Jonah. The ornament that represents this story, of course, is a picture of a big fish. God spoke to the people through prophets. And in Jonah, God wanted to speak to the people of Nineveh. They were disobedient, and God wanted to warn them to turn from their wicked ways or they would be punished. So God asked Jonah to go and speak to the people of Nineveh, and Jonah didn't want to do that. So he ran away. Jonah boarded a ship going in the opposite direction of Nineveh. But God saw him and caused a great storm to rise up, and Jonah was finally tossed overboard and swallowed by a big fish. So Jonah spent 3 days and nights in the belly of a whale before he confessed his disobedience and promised to go and speak for God to the people of Nineveh. Jonah's stay of 3 days and three nights foreshadows for us how long Jesus would be in the tomb after he died. So remembering the story of Jonah helps us understand who Jesus is and why he came to earth. So thank you for joining us today. Thank you, McCready's. Tune in tomorrow to hear from Allison Mills and learn about the next ornament on our Advent Jesse tree.